and welcome to our series Talk the Walk with Bharat Wani. I am your host, Erica Fernandez, and our guest for today is Santosh. He is the co-founder of Urban Tunes, and they are a footwear company that keeps in mind the needs of rural India. Now, isn't this inspiring? Now, before we get into this lovely organization, Santosh, can you please introduce yourself to our audience?
Sure. Thank you, Erica. So I'm Santosh Kochalakota. I'm one of the co-founders of Urban Tunes. We are actually a startup based out of Hyderabad. Although Erica had mentioned that we are a footwear company, I would just like to add to it. We are actually a social enterprise, and footwear for farmers is one of the first projects we are taking up.
Okay.
Having said that, we are a need-based company in the sense that our core domain doesn't mean that we actually make footwear or that we design something. We want to be present where there's a problem. So generally people tend to ask us, you know, what gives you the confidence or what makes you think that you can solve most of the problems?
Oh,
fair enough. That's a doubt to have. We are actually product designers from NID, National Institute of Design. So we believe our education at least equips us with the tools to understand the problem and understand and dissect it and arrive at a place where we can collaborate with the experts in the industry to actually solve the problem, not that we solve it ourselves.
Yeah.
So just to give you an example, before we started off with the footwear project, none of the founders knew anything about footwear.
Oh.
But what we did is we actually understood the needs of the users. And then we sat with the whole footwear supply chain, you know, be it manufacturers, raw materials, designers, and tried to understand where the needs that we found out for the farmers can be inculcated into the shoe in the best way possible.
Yeah.
Well, that's what we do.
Okay. What is your vision for your company, Urban Tunes?
Okay. So prior to actually starting off as Urban Tunes, the three of us knew that we wanted to do something for the farmers. We weren't sure, and we also felt it would be very wrong, you know, for us urban chaps to sit in a town or a city and judge what a farmer needs, right? So we set off, and we spent close to 6 to 7 months in villages, mainly in parts of Maharashtra, because that's where my other two co-founders are from.
Okay.
And it's not that we went with an agenda saying that these people are suffering and we need to do something for them. We just spent time with them. And truth be told, we actually understood a lot of other things, that these people's happiness index, I'm pretty sure, is much higher than what we have in urban India. But also there are some teething problems. So we were able to shortlist about 20 problems, which we came back to a drawing board. We listed them out.
Okay.
And out of those 20, we picked up 5.
Okay.
So the first problem of that is actually footwear. The other 4 are, is we are looking to make an alternative for a tractor.
Okay.
Because tractor is a very integral part of, but we feel that it's too oriented towards the rich farmers. Something has to be made for the smaller ones also.
Okay.
So that is one.
Mm-hmm.
Second thing is we are looking if we can address the problem of agro packaging. A huge amount of farm produce is wasted. Due to transportation and storage. But we have since only been using gunny sacks or jute bags, right? That is the third problem. Fourth one is we were seeing if we can come up with an affordable poly house. Poly house is basically an artificial environment you create for growing crops.
Oh.
Most of the poly houses are extremely expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So we were seeing if we could come up. And the fifth one is a franchise-based urban farming model. Although I think there are a few startups which are already doing that.
Yeah.
But this is the vision we had for Urban Tunes 3 years prior to when we started. And these are the 5 projects we wanted to take up for the next 10 years.
Oh, okay.
Right. So vision, I would say, is not that we, certainly for this next couple of years, we want as many farmers as possible to wear our shoes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have safe and happy feet.
Yeah.
That is the vision we have for the next 2 to 3 years.
So how did you come up with this idea that you wanted to start a social enterprise?
Social enterprise, right. So all three of us actually graduated from NID in 2017.
Okay.
And post that, we actually worked on a wheelchair project. It was for a startup based in Bombay. I'll just give you an educational background of what we did. We studied transportation design, all three of us, which is nowhere related to what we are doing now. We actually designed cars and bikes, right? The sketches that you see of how beautiful a car should look.
Okay.
But we were also taught what is known as design thinking in NID. What design thinking phase is, as I mentioned before, is you dissect a problem and try to understand, you know, where you can solve it.
Yeah.
This wheelchair project gave us the opportunity to actually put that design thinking into, you know, implementation. And that is when we realized the potential it had in solving the social problems that we face.
Yeah.
Right. We realized that you cannot look at a product just as a product, but it's always a part of a system. We tried to understand the system and we designed a wheelchair, electric wheelchair, which generally costs about 1 lakh or so, under 50,000. You can look it up. It's called Indent Designs, I-N-D-E-N-T. And the wheelchair's name is Ibex, I-B-E-E-X, for the viewers if you are interested.
Yeah.
Right. So that project got supported by IIT Bombay, by Government of Maharashtra. And then we realized that, you know, that this design thinking which you are applying has much more potential. So we came out of that company and then we got the confidence that we could start something on our own. And that's where we thought we'll take the bigger problems head on. We were really naive and probably very enthusiastic that, you know, we'll just straight away jump into it. So, yep, that's how.
That's nice. So, when we talk about your innovation right now, you know, let's talk about the shoes that you have for the farmers. How do you think, is there any like competitor that you have in the market?
None, actually. Unfortunately, the footwear that farmers wear are downgraded versions of what we have in urban India.
Oh, okay.
Let us say Crocs was a trend, right? Like a couple of years ago. So now you would find like cheap rip-offs of Crocs for rural India. Yeah.
Okay.
Additionally, India did have leather-based footwear, which is beautiful, local, and very sturdy. But that's all gone now because of advent of plastics. There are boots which people perceive work, but they do not. Boots have been provided by various governments, NGOs. For people who do not know, boots are actually the shoes that come up until your knees. Right? They're made of rubber. But they're horrible to use. They're very uncomfortable. So generally, farmer, even if they're given them for free, they are generally left unused or in a corner of their home. So there is a huge gap, and we felt there is a need to address it here.
Okay. Can you please describe, would you like to describe, you know, your the product, the shoes, a little bit more in detail for, you know, our audience to understand what is it like, or, you know, how does it benefit the farmer, etc.
Is it okay if I could share my screen?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Let's give you access.
Is my screen visible?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. So this is the market gap, just to answer the previous question that you asked. So the ones they wear, the farmers wear, they are on the extreme ends, right? They are either super comfy like flip-flops or multi-strap, but they are not very capable. So they hardly last for a couple of months. And on the other hand, you have gum boots, which are perceived to be capable, but they're horrible to use.
Oh.
Right? So we are seeing if we could, you know, achieve a sweet spot, which is like capable and both comfortable. Right? So our farmer footwear is called Yar. What's so unique about this shoe is the upper is made from indigenous wool, which goes by various names. It's called Gongadi, Kambali, It basically belongs to the Deccan region, which constitutes Karnataka, Andhra, Telangana.
Mm-hmm.
And this is actually sourced by the pastoral community. Generally, the pastoral communities, they are known by different names. Dangar, Kuruba, they are like a nomadic tribe, which keep roaming around. And they have like, each person in the community has at least 300 sheep.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So they keep rearing them and they keep going around. And this, the blankets that are made from the wool from this sheep is actually what is used by them. Typically, a blanket lasts for 25 years.
Okay.
20 to 25 years. You can use them throughout, you know, in summer, winter, and mm-hmm. rainy also.
Oh.
And one of the very few natural fibers which is actually water resistant. So that's where we got the idea. So see, if you want to make a rural farmer use a shoe, which is not mm-hmm. something he's very comfortable with,
mm-hmm.
you need to come up with a material that he relates to very well.
Yes.
So this wool is something they have know of, they have used it, they have slept on the blanket, mm-hmm. they have seen their grandparents use it. It is also known to have some therapeutic effects.
Oh.
Right? Yeah. So that is where we got the idea that why not we make a shoe for the rural community.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But then you just can't straight away take the material and make a shoe. You also need to understand the nuances of the comfort of the shoe, right? For example, generally our footwear tend to have this as a tongue. Tongue is the movable part you have between the laces, right?
Mm-hmm.
But that wouldn't work for rural farmer because he walks in like water conditions.
Yeah.
And the tongue starts to slip out.
Oh.
Right? That's the reason we have gone with a unified monobody construction. And second thing, they have big toenails. So generally, farmers don't cut their nails, right?
Huh.
So generally, any shoe that they wear, it starts tearing off here because it's deeper. So we have provided reinforcements here.
Oh.
So small changes, which were but very much made for farmers, is what we have done. Second thing, we try to make the ingress-egress, that is the process of wearing the shoe, as easy as possible.
Oh.
Right? So that's why we have this wide mouth construction. And farmers tend to have like wide feet.
Hmm.
So we have tried to go with a wide, as much wide sole as possible in the market. So small things like these. But coming to the features of the shoe, let us say, very cool thing is, as I said, it thermoregulates, right? Whatever is the condition outside. Summer, winter, rainy, it keeps your feet comfortable. Unlike generally wool is related to winter, that's not the case with indigenous wool. It keeps you comfortable in summer also, right?
Okay.
Then we have gone with a molded shoe construction. Most of the footwear that we wear, generally probably the one you are wearing also, the upper and the lower part are actually stuck together by some sort of a gum. Right? But that generally fails when you walk, if you keep it for a long time in water conditions, or you walk in slush, right? The upper part.
So we
did not use adhesive here. We have gone with a molded construction. And that's like super strong. And we got that tested also at in a lab in Chennai.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it is like, it will take like 4 to 5 people to actually pull it out. So that's our shoe.
That's amazing. Y'all have really in detail, you know, heard the farmers' concerns and then implemented it in this shoe, which is amazing to see. And what I really like the best is that, you know, I've seen a lot of people saying, you know, it helps them, but then the design is not that great. And this design is so, like, you know, to the mark with the standards, you know, with the current trends, I must say. So I really like that.
Thank you.
Okay. So can you share an interesting story or, you know, something that happened during while you were innovating this product? Like an interesting or a funny story that happened.
Is my screen visible still?
Yes. Close the thing. Do we need the presentation?
I'll just visual reference is important for what I'm about to show.
And I can still see you, so don't worry.
Acha. So this is a lady. So before arriving at the final design, we actually did a pilot. you know, we made a shoe prototype and we again went back to villages to understand where we could improve.
Okay.
So this is a lady whom we met in a rural part of Maharashtra. And although we designed the shoes for men, she was very keen. Like, she approached us at the farm and told, you know, you give me a pair, I want to use this.
Okay.
Right? And yeah. And she used this for like 4 to 5 hours because we were on a short notice, so we had to go. And she was actually one of the first persons who gave us this confidence that this shoe will actually work.
Oh.
Right? And she actually showed her feet, which were like in a very bad state. Right? And in spite of we insisting ki aapke liye bani nahi hai, aapke liye bani nahi hai, even though her feet were small, she tied those laces around her ankles and she used it.
Wow.
So that is how dire the need is actually. And that's when we really felt ki isme ye sab enterprise wo sab acha hai. I'm not denying it. We need to make profit.
Yeah.
But I think the cause is much larger than that. It's like, let us say, Adidas doesn't make shoes tomorrow. It's not that everyone starts walking barefoot, right? They have a lot of alternatives. But hame kabhi aisa lagta ki ye, it's a responsibility and an opportunity for us also ki hum log shoes nahi banayenge to koi na koi barefoot chal raha hai.
Yes.
So we need to try as much as possible. So
that was sweet. That's a sweet story. That's it. Okay. Are there any challenges that your firm is facing right now, and you know, what are the solutions that you have thought about?
Right. So this wool, interestingly, is actually sourced directly from weavers. And weavers are like a very distributed community, and what we are trying to do is integrate a craft into a mass-produced product.
Okay.
And that's where quality becomes a challenge, right?
Mm.
So every blanket that is woven by them is different. So let us say I want to make a black shoe, not all blacks match.
Yeah.
Right? So that is a challenge that we are facing. We want to standardize a craft, which is very difficult actually. You need to sit with the weavers.
Yeah.
And it's not a mass producing thing, right? It's not made on a machine. Right. So you have to make sure that the wool that is sourced is a specific black color.
Mm.
And that is woven in a specific manner. So we are trying to figure out, there is no literature available on this. So we are trying to figure out sitting with the weaving community. In fact, that's a very striking thing we observed. There is very less or hardly any literature related to anything which is rural India.
Oh.
For example, right, I'll give you there is no good statistic evaluation of farmers' feet until now. Can you believe it? Farmers' feet are known to be larger, but no one knows what is the size distribution.
Wow.
For urban, we follow UK standards, but farmer ke liye it is way different. Therein, there is nothing to actually document it.
Wow.
So most of the shoe sizes that we make, sometimes they're too large or they're too small.
Yeah.
And there is, we cannot do anything Abhi, because these are the standard things that the industry is following.
Yes.
So these are few challenges. Hopefully some we'll solve it in coming years.
How much literature is there like on farm work?
Very less actually. Matlab, it's so bad that agar aapko janna hai, let us say you want to find out how many farmers are in a district also. The numbers are very, very wonky. Matlab, it's like 1 million to 2 million. I said the numbers are. It's very difficult, right? 1 million to 2 million is like a million difference.
Exactly. wow.
But there are challenges. I mean, you can't blame the statistician because farming is not like a profession people take throughout the year. Right, it's like sometimes the women of the homes believe that they need income for the next 4 months, they'll work. Right, for the next remaining 8 months, they'll not work. So it's not that straightforward. But I think something needs to be done in that direction also. Hopefully this Aadhaar and all that is helping.
Yeah, that's true. Okay. Is there any message or advice that you would like to give aspiring entrepreneurs?
One thing I would say is we generally have a tendency in India to understand the problems of the people through literature. Let us say, for example, I want to understand, I decide that I want to make an innovation for doctors, right? I sit around and read all the problems that are there. I'm not saying it's a bad approach, but the problem with this is you'll only arrive at solutions which are already there. You'll only end up making a cheaper version of what is already there.
Yeah.
Right? But if you truly want to make something which is like a breakthrough or which no one has seen, you have to start off with talking to people.
Mm.
Right? Which is what we were taught in our college also. For us, literature research is never the foreground thing.
Yeah.
It comes much later. Okay. It is very important that you form an opinion of what the problem is.
Mm.
Not read what others feel what the problem is.
True.
Like someone from outside India comes and judges what is required in rural India. I think it's vulgar. It's wrong. You know, someone from outside India or some expert telling us what is needed in India.
Mm.
You are an Indian and you should be the first one to understand what your own problems are.
Yeah.
Right. So that's what I hope people actually go and talk to people. Entrepreneurs go and talk to as many people as possible.
True.
Before coming to literature. So yes.
Okay. Can you tell us, what is your way forward? What is going to come next for you guys?
Sure. So we are being incubated by IIT Madras. IIT Madras has an incubator called Rural Technology Business Incubator, which is focused on innovations for rural India. They have been very supportive. So they have given us a seed fund, about 10 lakhs or so. And the shoes that you see are actually a batch that we made from those 10 lakhs. But what we are looking way forward is we are trying to raise funds to make more pairs, right? So that we can have like a large amount of money and pairs in rotation. And the challenge that we also have as of now is reaching farmers directly as marketing campaigns is not straightforward because of the diversity that India has, right?
Mm.
I have to have local language campaigns. The crop diversity is large, right? For example, the lady you see here, she is growing a specific kind of crop.
Mm.
Then there are other like paddy, sugarcane and such things. So we are seeing how we can figure out the best way to market to such diverse population,
right?
So fundraising and marketing is our like immediate goals, which we are working on actively.
Okay. Is there any last message or anything that you would like to tell our audience before we end this interview?
I believe everyone who are the listeners are, you should visit rural parts of India as much as possible. A lot of these glass ceilings that we have, they shatter quite brilliantly once you go to a rural India. There's so much to learn, understand from what rural India has to offer. And that is actually, in my opinion, what truly India stands for. Yeh sustainability, green, yeh sab jo hip words ban gaye hain, rural India actually lives it. For them, it's a breathing thing. You don't need to tell them that they need to use an earthen pot. They already use it, right? You don't need to tell them ki aap woven basket use karo, plastic cup use karo. Most of them know it. It comes naturally to them. So probably there's a lot to learn from there. So I hope that some of you visit rural India.
That's it. Thank you so much, Santosh, for your time, and it was lovely knowing about your company. Social aspect that y'all are trying to achieve. All the best, and I really hope to hear so much more from you and from Modern Day.
Thank you.